haven't seen Wally. He needs to be here for our...
Oh, there you are, Wally.
Let's get ready. No, what are you doing, Wally?
No. Oh, no. Wally!
Oh, cut. All right, let's switch out cameras. Okay, I think we're back on. But now where did he go? Wally! Oh, it's not your desk, Wally. Come on. We have students waiting for us. Wally! I can't be chasing you around. Oh, my goodness. I need to say hello to my students. Hello, everyone. How is everyone today? My name is Erin, talking to you from Goddard Space Flight Center in Maryland, and I am so excited to be talking to you all today about the moon. We're going to be learning today about how we're using satellites today to explore the moon. Are you ready? Great. Well, I have one more question for you, boys and girls. Have you all seen Wally? I can't seem to find... Oh, there you are. Everyone say hello, Wally. He's going to be joining us today and sharing with you all what he's learned here at NASA. So let's get started. Boys and girls, when you hear the word NASA, what first comes to mind? Those were great things to think of. And if you all were going to say astronauts, most people think of astronauts when they hear the word NASA. They think of our human spaceflight program, but not many people realize that we explore most of space without using those astronauts. We use robots. We use satellites to take a look at these things in space. And today, we're going to be learning about those today. So are you ready? Fantastic. Wally wants to come in and share with you all what he's learned here at NASA. So everyone say, come on in, Wally. Great job. Here he comes. All right, what is this, everyone? An astronaut, very good. Our astronauts are the men and women who live and work in space. They train down in Houston, Texas at NASA Johnson Space Center. This is great, Wally. What's next? Very good. Can anyone tell me what this is? Excellent. The International Space Station, or ISS for short. This is our space station, our home to not only American astronauts, but also international astronauts as well. This is an international mission. 16 countries, including the United States, all live and work on board the ISS. Up to 6 astronauts can live on board the space station for anywhere between 3 to 6 months. Fantastic, Wally. What is next? Oh, very good. I think we all know what this is, everyone. Our planet Earth. Excellent. Who can tell me some reasons why our planet is so special? Terrific. Our planet Earth is the only planet that we know of that has life, and we're able to explore it using satellites. And we can explore a lot of other things in space using satellites. I think Wally has some other things he'd like to share with you. Oh, very good. What is this, everyone? The moon. Excellent. When can we usually see the moon in our sky, boys and girls? At nighttime. Very good. We can see the moon during the daytime, but there's something else in the sky during the day. What else is in our sky? The sun. That's right. And we're able to take a look at the sun with the help of satellites. In fact, here is a picture of a sun, of our sun, with a satellite. Now, does our sun look like this in our sky here on Earth? No, it does not. Here's another reason why we use satellites to explore space, boys and girls. We can take a look at objects like our sun and understand what they really look like. Wally, these were terrific. Everyone say, thanks, Wally. And we will see you in just a couple minutes. Now, I've been talking about these satellites, and we have lots of satellites exploring space. In fact, one satellite here at Goddard Space Flight Center that is very near and dear to our heart is called the Hubble Space Telescope. How many of you, by a show of hands, have ever heard of Hubble before? I'm sure you've seen the beautiful images we've captured with the help of Hubble over its 20-year mission. Thanks to the Hubble Space Telescope, we have learned valuable information such as about the Eagle Nebula or other objects in our universe, and it helped us understand all the information that there is to know about our universe. And coming here closer to Earth, we have lots of other satellites taking a look at our own planet, as well as the moon. Now today we're going to be talking about a satellite that has been exploring the moon and is helping us get us ready for future human exploration. We're going to be training a very special group of people. In fact, I would like you all to take a look around your classmates right now. Just take a look around. You are looking at the future men and women who will be walking on the moon, on asteroids, maybe even Mars one day. How many of you want to walk in those places? Raise your hands really high. Fantastic. Well, Wally wants to come in and give you a sneak peek at what you could be looking at outside your spacecraft window. Are you ready? I'm excited. Let's take a look. Wow, wasn't that exciting? Now, how many of you want to go to the moon one day? Raise your hands really high. Excellent. Let's take a look at how we're getting ready for your future missions with the help of a satellite today. This satellite is called the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, or, thank you, Wally, LRO. LRO is a machine. On board, we have lots of different types of instruments and cameras. One instrument that we're using is helping us make a brand new map of the moon. But why do you think we need a brand new map of the moon, boys and girls? Those are all great reasons. We're making a very special type of map that shows us where all the different types of landforms are located on the moon. This has a very special name. Are you ready for it? Repeat after me. Topographic map. Very good. This topographic map shows us where all the different landforms are located in different colors, much like the map right behind me. What are we taking a look at right here, boys and girls? The United States of America. Very good. So here we can see lots of different types of landforms on our country, on the land, in different colors. I see lots of green in the middle. That indicates all the different flat land. I also see lots of brown out west. This is indicating where the mountains are located in our country. So again, we're making the type of map, this topographic map of the moon, so we will know where to have you land safely and where you can explore safely on the moon. All valuable, oh my gosh! What was that, Wally? Oh, that was scary. Well, maybe we can get back to the map in just a few minutes. That's just one way we're using LRO to get ready for your future missions. We're also using the satellite to look for a very important resource. It's very important for us here on Earth and just as important for your future missions. Wally wants to come in and give you a hint of what we're looking for. So come on in, Wally.
Oh.
While he is drying himself off, maybe you all can tell me, what are we looking for on the moon? Water, exactly right. Let's think of some ways that water is so important for us here on Earth. We can drink water. We use water to stay healthy. We use water to stay nice and cool. And we also use water to stay nice and clean. But those are also great ways to use water on the moon. Boys and girls, when you go off to the moon or the asteroids or any other location away from Earth, you may be staying for a very long time period, which will mean a lot of water will be needed for you and your crewmates to use every single day. During your missions, you'll be using water to drink, to stay healthy, to stay cool in your spacesuits, and stay clean because, boys and girls, nobody likes a stinky astronaut. So you all can take baths on the moon, is that okay? Oh, thank goodness. Rather than packing up all the water that you'll need here on Earth, which will take up lots of space on your spacecraft and lots of rocket fuel to lift it off the ground, we may have found water on the moon that could be a resource available for your future missions. Now, we're looking in a very special location. I know Wally wants to give you a hint of where we're looking, but he's a little embarrassed from last time. So, do you think you all can help me out? Great! Maybe you all can just say, come on back in, Wally! Oh, great job, everyone. Here he comes. Oh, silly Wally. What was he trying to throw away there, boys and girls? A magnet. Very good. Give me a thumbs up if you have ever used a magnet in science class before. Excellent. Well, then tell me, what have you seen when you use a magnet in science class? Very good. Magnets can stick to metal. Sometimes they're pushed away from metal. And this all happens at the ends of magnets. Does anyone happen to know the special name we have for the ends of magnets? I'll give you a hint. We have them here on planet Earth. Our planet Earth has a north and south pole, just like a magnet. And did you know? So does the moon. That is where we're looking for water for your future missions. Now, why are we looking for water? Well, thank you, Wally. Let's take a look, closer look at the moon. Here in the northern and southern pole regions, these areas are almost constantly in shadow. So scientists thought that they may be able to find water in the form of ice locked into the rocks or at the bottoms of craters. Now, in order to find this water, engineers designed another robot called LCROSS, attached to two LRO, and these two traveled together to the moon. Once LRO arrived in orbit around the moon, LCROSS detached, traveled down to the moon's surface, and then slammed into the dirt as hard as it could, kicking up lots of dust and hopefully some water ice. Then, LRO went through the dust cloud, scanned its contents, and sent back all the information to scientists waiting here at NASA. Now, those scientists have been able to look through all of the data gathered from the LCROSS mission, and we have found an answer. Are you ready for it? Drum roll, please. Stop. We found water on the moon, boys and girls. This is great news for your future missions. Because from the LCROSS mission, scientists now predict that we may have gallons and gallons of water available for your future missions already on the moon. So you'll be able to drink the water, stay healthy, stay cool in your spacesuits, and stay clean because remember, boys and girls, nobody likes a stinky astronaut. Exactly right. We learned so much today about the moon and how we're exploring it with the help of a satellite, how we're making a brand new map of the moon, and we're also looking for water. Unfortunately, we've run out of time today. So I would like to say thank you so much for joining me today. And I think one more person wants to come out and say goodbye. Wally, come on out. Everyone give a big round of applause to Wally. Thank you so much. He had so much fun with you today, and so did I. Woo! Thanks again for joining me today, and on behalf of everyone here at the DLN, have a great day. Goodbye, everyone. Take care. Wow.